first one is my other piece that is a true piece. You might not be able to hear me, fireworks, what's going on?
Buongiorno, this is Ken and welcome back to my channel Ken Travels 360. Previously on Andiamo in Campania, we spent a bit more time in Naples before spending the afternoon in Herculaneum visiting the archaeological ruins there. Afterwards, we drove to Paestum where we were staying 2 nights at this hotel, Paestum Inn Beach Resort. Let's start this episode when we woke up the next morning and were going to the hotel restaurant for breakfast. The hotel has a nice swimming pool. We shall be using it later.
The breakfast buffet is quite good. It's got fruits. It got all sorts of ham, salami, prosciutto. And something that is famous here is the buffalo cheese. They have buffalo mozzarella. They have buffalo ricotta cheese. And even the yogurt is made of buffalo milk. And the dessert, yes, dessert for breakfast is really good as well. It's plum cake, ricotta cheese and chocolate cake, jam tart, apple pie, fruit tart. It's quite amazing.
After breakfast, we went straight to Paestum Archaeological Park, which is UNESCO Heritage listed, by the way. Paestum was originally known as Poseidonia, and it was an ancient Greek colony. During the peak of the ancient Greek civilizations, its citizens set out to form dozens of new colonies around the Mediterranean, and this was one of them. They built 3 impressive Greek temples of Doric orders, dedicated to ancient Greek gods. The first structure that greets you as you enter the site is Tempio di Neptuno, Temple of Neptune, which was constructed around 450 BC. It's the largest and best preserved of the 3 main temples at Paestum. Parts of its inside walls and roof are still there. What made these Greek temples at Paestum so special is that they are still in very good condition. In fact, they are the best preserved ancient Greek temples in the world, including Greece itself.
Next to the Temple of Neptuno is the Tempio di Hera, the Hera Temple. It's one of the oldest and of the grand temples, the Doric temples, on this site. Well, its construction took 40 years, from 560 BC to 520 BC. Elegant and refined, this temple measures 24.5 × 50.3 meters. So this is the back of the temples facing west.
When the Romans colonized Paestum after 273 BC, they found Greek gods and Greek temples, so they built their own temples too. This is the ruins of the Temple of Peace, but it didn't preserve as well as the Greek Doric temples.
This last temple, this beautiful temple, is Temple of Athena. This was built at the end of the 6th century BC. It stands on a 3-tier base. The main hall is surrounded by a lot of Doric columns.
Originally, people thought this temple was dedicated to Ceres, but due to the discovery of numerous statues in terracotta depicting Athena, it is now thought to have been dedicated to Athena instead. For many visitors to Naples and the Sorrento Peninsula, Pompeii might be the most popular day trip. However, the Paestum temples, which are UNESCO Heritage listed, are equally magnificent. For whatever reasons, Paestum temples are not on international visitors' radar as much, but as you can see in this video, it deserves a lot more visitors. Right, we are finished with the temples, but we are not done yet.
So the ticket for the Paestum archaeological site also includes admission to the museum. This one is a chamber tomb with double burial, male and female.
From the excavation of the tombs, they have recovered many vases. Although there are lots of things to see in the museum, the most important part is probably the tomb of the diver. It is an incredible painted tomb that is from the ancient Greek period and dated around 470 BC. It's called the Tomb of the Diver because of the painted ceiling of the tomb that shows a young man diving into the water, a symbol of passing into the afterlife. And the other fascinating part is that the painted scene on the other walls of the tombs that show social scenes and homosexual lovers. Right, we probably have seen enough museum exhibits now. Let's get back outside.
So, more signs of buffalo milk in this town. There's even buffalo milk skincare product.
We had lunch at a local restaurant where the food was quite ordinary and then it got quite hot. So we decided to get back to the hotel to use the swimming pool and beach before heading out later in the afternoon. If you have been enjoying this video, please give me a thumbs up. And if you would like to continue to follow this series, please subscribe to my channel and click the notifications bell icon.
So we just arrived at the hilltop town of Castellabate.
Castellabate is the prettiest part of the Cilento. The medieval castle town stands above the sapphire waters of the Mediterranean. It had a recent starring role in a popular film, Benvenuti al Sud, Welcome to the South, which highlighted its beauty and hospitality.
Further afield, you can see the Amalfi Coast. It's a bit hazy today, so you can't really see that well. So unexpectedly, the Castello dell'Abate is open, despite Google Maps saying it's only open in the morning. Inside, there's quite a bit of artwork, and there's a model of the town.
At the base of Castellabate, there's a church with its clock tower. In the afternoon sun, they're looking golden. The church inside is nothing fancy, but there was a mass going on at the time.
So as we return to the car park lot, suddenly we find a lot of Fiat Cinquecento. It looks like there is a Fiat Cinquecento club here. A meeting of some sort. All sorts of different colors of Fiat Cinquecento.
After Castellabate, there was still some time before dinner, so we check out this town, Agropoli, which you could see earlier up there.
So, just arrived at the Aragonese castle at Agropoli.
The castle itself was not that interesting, but the view was good. Right, it's time for dinner. However, my attempt to show you the pizzas that we have ordered was interrupted by some unexpected events.
So, for the first time this week, I ordered pizza. Pizza, true, pizza. You might not be able to hear me, fireworks is going on.
What have you ordered?
Volcano special.
Ah. And you got fireworks to celebrate as well.
Thank you for watching this video. Next time, we'll continue the second part of our road trip. We'll visit the hidden gem, Salerno Duomo, which has this most incredible crypt, where the frescoes are absolutely wonderful. Afterwards, we'll drive on the famous Amalfi Coast, and we'll stay at Minori for the night. For those who are following these videos real time, this series will take a short break and it will return in autumn, as I want to cover some other trips first. See you next time. Ciao.